introduced a Western saddle the last time we worked with him. And what we saw with him is even though he had been saddled with a Purfingal, even saddled with an English saddle twice, with the introduction of the Western saddle, he did become startled and he did have a bucking response. Had that been me, the rider, I certainly would not have stayed on him. So we are acknowledging that he had a little bit of trouble with the weight of the saddle or the sound of the saddle, and we're going to work forward to help him work through those problems. Today we're long lining him, which is basically like riding the horse from the ground, preparing him not only for steering and stopping, but it also creates movement of the stirrups where my feet would be. And you can see him look and turn at that. He wasn't sure what that was, and that would have been my leg. So I'm gonna move the stirrup again, and you can see he had a little bit of a startle response to this horse. And I just wanna make sure that that startle response is gone before my foot is in that stirrup. I'm doing all of this with a Basel because this is all very new in pressure and relief. I am not gonna use a bit on this horse until he's stopping and going and turning and all of the, all of the spooky behavior is gone in the Basel because I don't want him to hurt his mouth. I also want to make sure that my dentist comes and removes any wolf teeth that are there and that he gets floated and he has a bit seat before he is done any work with this. But so this is all stuff I need to use in the Basel. And a bit's not required for this work. Again, I want to touch him a little bit with the stirrup. He started to walk away and he's not turning, and this would happen if I was riding him. We'll try it again. He didn't listen to the pressure on his toes. I'll try another change of direction. Again, that's going to be my one, it's going to turn into my one rein stop. Start the outside rein. That was better. Very good. Very good. Very good. All right, so this is way more relaxed. Head's a little bit lower. You're not rushing off. I had a problem with giving him the pressure of the right rein, so I'm going to try this right side again. And you can see his response is to push against pressure. Did you see how his nose came to the left instead of to the right? And now he's going to run away from the pressure. Oh, I need to know about that. I get on him. Obviously not turning right today. So he tried to run away from the track of that right rein. And we've seen from the other work we've done with this horse that he doesn't like going to the right anyway. He keeps trying to change direction. He much prefer me to be on his left side instead of his right side. So all of this is very closely related. He doesn't want to go to the right. Most horses are left-handed, just like most people are right-handed. So he's definitely a left-handed horse. He just preferred not to have me on his right side. And that time he knew what I wanted and he kind of ran away from it. So I wasn't planning on asking him to turn, but I did shorten my rein a little bit. He's very smart, he saw that. And he trotted forward because he didn't want to make that turn. He knew what I was doing. Let's see if he does the same thing this way. A little bit of right rein. He's pushing against it. He's pushing against it. He's pushing against it. He's pushing again. Oh my goodness. There we go. And it's not always going to be perfect when they're learning. I put a lot of muscle in that, but aren't we glad that he has Basel on and not a bit in order to learn about that? He didn't need to learn about that with a bit, he just needed to learn about pressure and release. And I 100% guarantee he'll do it with a bit when we get to that. But it was important for me not to cause any harm to his mouth, but I had to use a lot of pressure to get him to turn. But if I ask him to turn, he must turn. Going to the right, still looks a little tense. See how high his neck is going to the right. Oh, very important. Kind of too high for my liking. his head drop down a little bit here in a second. Another note that I think is important to mention when doing the long lining is I have two lines that are 22 feet long. The lines are rolled. They're not flat ones lines. And when they're rolled like this, they slide better and they are much less likely to get tangled around my arm because they are round and not flat. Also important to remember to use gloves and to make sure you do not have spurs on your boots, because these lines can and will get wrapped around a spur, and that's a safety issue. So those are important things about using the long lines that I always tell everyone. Okay, take these off.